Hey, how's it going, guys? JC here, and today we have a match against Echo with Thunderlords. OP.GG, Runes and Masteries will be on the screen right now. I'm slightly nervous with this game because they have a LeBlanc, you know? I always ban LeBlanc, and this time I was told by my teammate, you have to ban Kassadin. And then, you know, I was the last person to ban, so I obliged, and this is what happens. LeBlanc gets picked, so very unfortunate. The Echo, I think, will look to shove us in non-stop, so the moment he throws his Q out, I'm going to probably go on him for a short trade. Just like that. Just to punish the fact that he has no Q. And I guess he's just going to repetitively do that, so I get to fight him again. Or force him to miss CS. So that's one way to do it. It's just to punish him for wasting his cooldowns. Okay. Gonna let that minion tank, and then we're gonna deny him that CS. Very nice. So this next minion's gonna get us level 2. Didn't quite get the spin I wanted. It was decent though, but wasn't the best. Have to watch out for the 3-minute mark. I wanted to push this in, so that this reaches the tower, or crashes into the tower so it can reset back to me. And let's see, Kha'Zix? Kha'Zix doesn't clear that fast, but I'm gonna put a ward here just in case. I'm not threatened by him ganking from this angle, so here is the must. You just must ward that angle, because that's where he can gank from, where you'll be in trouble. Okay, we're level 3. Can look for another short trade, or at least to deny that minion. Didn't get the trade I wanted, but that's okay. He's gonna throw his Q again. I'm gonna wait for him to throw his Q, and then I'm gonna get some CS. Or maybe I won't. Alright, he's just going to throw it directly at me, so it's not going to push as fast. First blood on the Ezreal, very nice. I see the Kha'Zix's location, so that's huge. So I will try to respond to the Graves if I can. Let's see. I want to hit level 4 as well. I feel like Kha'Zix is... Oh, I'm dead. Yeah, I feel like that Kha'Zix is really close, so that... I should have used my gut instinct and just back off right away. I feel like that Graves... The gank kind of messed me up. Oh, very nice. Okay, it's not that bad then. It's actually not too bad. Because this wave is pushing to me, I believe. Oh, no, it's not. Just kidding. That is so unfortunate then. I hope these two can die really quickly and then... if the cannon can focus the right target. It's kind of a rough start at the moment, just because we died like that, and it's pushing towards him. Oh, he did teleport on a caster minion, so that means it's going to push even further into him, which is really annoying unless he starts shoving that out. So we're going to have to try to break the freeze. We are level 3 still, and he's level 4, so this is looking really bad for us. But we should be able to come back from this. Hopefully be able to freeze it later on. Or do something. Actually, freezing's not very good against the Echo with teleport. Especially when he can do that to us. So, I'm looking to fight him soon. Oh no, he's level 5 now. I have to wait till I'm level 5 or at least level 6 and then I can look for an all-in. At the very minimum, I have to be level 5. Okay, actually, I shouldn't have warded there because I saw the Kha'Zix. He's gonna try to throw the Q at me. Okay, there it is. As long as you move away from the second half of it, you're good to go. Alright, we have to back off because he used his W. But now we get to pop our potions and hopefully we'll hit level 5 soon and be able to just all in him. Very nice. Very nice, we got him. That's just what I wanted, just to all in him, and now we can set up this freeze. I was just waiting for the level 5 all in because we do take ignite for a reason. So actually this might not freeze as well as I would have hoped. I wonder if he has teleport. I didn't pay attention to his teleport, so I'm actually not sure. See, 1, 2, 3, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, no, never mind. It is going to freeze. Okay. Since this is going to slow push back into me. Man. I kind of want to stay, actually. I'm going to stay. I feel like I can pressure this Echo, or at least do a lot to him. And also, the Graves is coming, so this is going to be very important. Nice. Okay. This is a good timing for the gank. I need to avoid his thing. Oh, wow, he's actually gonna escape. Which way is he gonna go? That way. Ah, this is such a fiesta. Very nice. And, oh, can I get the slow off? Oh, never mind. Have to get out. Hey, that Ezreal ult looks different. Is that like a reworked post fight Ezreal? Or something like that? That was a really strange looking ult. Okay. Just give up that jungle. I'm not in a position to fight. I really want to get this CS, so I'm gonna fall so far behind. Like, there's no reason to fight. Just let them have whatever the empty jungle. I don't see the reason to fight. It's a blue buff, it's not worth it. Okay. Alright, this is very good. I pulled the minions back, so this is going to freeze really nicely. And we're going to be able to just out macro the Echo that kind of did a number on us earlier. And our Ignite's actually coming up soon, so I want to look for some short trades here because I have full fury. So if I can look for just any short trade, that would be awesome. Oh, what? We got stunned anyway. That's unfortunate. So he actually predicted me to spin back. That's very smart of him. I guess he recognized my playstyle and he predicted correctly. But either way, that's still fine. I'm gonna look to kill him very soon. Oh no, they're fighting. Oh, Ripperino. Why is there four top again? Okay. They really want that blue. I'm coming. I think we can do this. We can contest this. Another Ezreal ult to the top lane. Well, I didn't really do anything. All I did was just show that I was going down there, so they just back off. Okay, he's going back. That's really interesting considering I don't want him to go back. Ouch. That's a Thunderlord. Okay. I'm looking to cancel his recall. Oh, he already went really far back. I can tell because of my W. So I'm going to shove this out and just go back myself. Okay, and this should crash into the tower quite nicely. I hope. Yep, there we go. Very nicely. So this is going to push back into us. I believe this game might be a Merc Treads game just because of the LeBlanc CC. There's the Bard. There's the Echo. But I feel like the Kha'Zix can one-shot us if we go for Merc Treads, so I think this is also a Death Dance game. And especially with a LeBlanc running around. With a 2-1 LeBlanc, she's relatively strong. One of them's real. One of them's fake. The heck? That one's probably fake. The one that just went into red buff. Oh. Echo's missing right now, so want to make sure. Okay, he's here. Just always look to do some short trades after EQs. Like right now. Just always do some short trades and just watch out for his W. Oh wow, he actually directed that Q quite well. So we're gonna have to back off because he actually did quite a good job with his Q and his trade. We can heal up back to full pretty easily. And this is going to be a huge wave, so we kind of just traded and wasted his potion and also his mana. So the mana is probably the more important part. And we didn't lose anything in the process, so that's the thing. Okay, he's backing off. Oh my god, he's teleporting. Okay. I don't think he's gonna get much out of it. I'm going to try to push this in as far as I can. My team's actually doing work, so I'm really happy that the teleport actually backfired. That's part of the reason why I don't really like to have teleport as well. Sometimes, you know, I'm pressured to not concentrate on my lane and potentially even lose my lane. I also lose a lot of kill pressure, and if I do a bad teleport, that's just game over. Yeah, I'm just not a big fan of teleport. Like, in most cases, I only take it because it's a very tough matchup, and I could use it to potentially flank or gank bot lane, but otherwise, I much prefer Ignite. Okay. He was very keen to actually trade with us instead of get CS, so that's really interesting. And we got Bard up here, so we just pulled two top, and we lost absolutely nothing. We get to heal up with this plant, and off we go. I feel like every short trade with Echo is really good, as long as you don't take too much more damage than he does, and obviously you survive it as well, then you're in a good position to lane against him. Okay, very nice. We just wasted so much mana out of him, and that's just going to help us so much. Because I'm looking to fight him again, right here. And he runs so fast though. There we go, very nice. I guess I didn't have to ignite it. Oh, I'm coming.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Okay, he has it. Wow, that Graves is so strong. Actually, he's 4-4. He did feed a little bit. But for the most part, Graves so strong. Okay, let's push this in, and I don't think we can get a tower before he comes back to lane. I'm not sure if he has teleport. Actually, no, he does not have teleport because he used that to gank bot, and luckily they survived. So, actually, no, this is a tower. Is it first blood? Oh, okay. Well, we're gonna get two towers then. I'm going to be able to push this in, and then go back to get my Shiv. Oh, by the way, I saw the new Tryndamere skin. Not a fan of it. It looks really ugly. Okay, I'm coming. I'm coming. Oh, jeez.
Chill out.
Alright, she flashed. Oh, rip. I tried to get to her side. Ah, very nice, very nice. Okay, so now we can buy a lot of items. I think I'm still inclined to get Death Stance this game. But I will get a Merc Treads. Actually, my PD though. I love PD. I'm going to get these two. And then I'm going to go for a Merc Treads and a Death Stance. But I really like Bork too. I think I have to skip out on the Bork so I can, in favor of IE. So that might be the plan, guys. That might just be the plan. Oh, Rift Herald. If we get Rift Herald, I can use it bot lane. Bot lane's such a good place to use Rift Herald. Just whichever has more towers on one side. Oh man, I might lose a lot top lane though. Okay, they know. Never mind. I have to go. There was a ward here that just spotted the Rift Herald. I'm 100% sure that spotted the Rift Herald, so we had to stop the Rift Herald, unfortunate. I might go for it later, though. So I'll push out one more wave, and then I'll go for it. But we know there's a ward here at the river. So we also see Kha'Zix is over there. I know that this pit's not warded, so we can take this plant over. It gives them one less option to scout out that we're doing Rift Herald. And as long as we stay in the pit, they shouldn't be able to spot us because our pink ward is telling us so, that there is no wards here. After I take this, I can push out top and then roam somewhere to drop the Rift Herald. And hopefully my team would actually protect the Rift Herald, like, you know, follow up, and we should be Gucci. Alright, there we go, drop the ward, replace it with... I should have dropped two wards actually, but too late. So we push the top lane out and then we start roaming. This is where we become a little bit more useful for our team. But I'm going to push one more. I just saw the LeBlanc. I don't think she can reach here quick enough, but I'm going to save my E. Save my E to spin away. And now we just go and roam, but we go like a safe route. I feel like... Actually, that Echo is going to push so fast. Mission top. Alright, split bot. Oh, wow, there's a Fiesta happening here. Okay. There's a bard there, that's annoying. Ooh! No, no, I was meant to ult! No, I'm so boosted! I was pressing ult! Ah, Jesus, that's so bad of me. Ah, my bad, my bad. Oh, that was such a huge mess up. I'm so sorry, guys. Oh, okay. I guess I'm not the only one. Oh, I guess he's not the only one. No, 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 no. Wait, I saw a Kha'Zix. Okay, so pickaxe is going to be a death stance and the boot's going to be merc treads, alright? There we go. And, oh, look at that. It's actually Pulse Fire Ezreal, but it looks slightly different. And I'm proud to say that I have that skin. Okay, we're going to just summon the Rift Herald and, you know, go ham for bot lane. Oh, no. Man, I can't believe I threw that. This is a really free game, so I hope that my death didn't mean that it's game over and we lost just because of that. So hopefully we can get another tower off of this. Just one more, hopefully. I see two, so that means potentially three could be coming bot. So kind of scary. I want to support the Rift Herald right away. If at all possible. Doesn't look like it, though. Doesn't look like it. LeBlanc's coming as well. Is LeBlanc... Does she know I'm here, though? That's the question. Alright, I'm out anyway. She's a very slippery champion, and I really don't like her. She has so many roots, so many slows, and so many gap closes that... Or escapes that I just feel like it's almost impossible to catch her. If this... Oh, rip. I'm going to push this out anyway. The Ezreal now knows that I'm there, so... What? Interesting. Wait, did he seriously just not know I was there? Oh no. Oh no, this is happening. Hey, we're actually winning this because they tower dove. What the heck? Very nice. That Ezreal, so much disrespect. Like, I'm a Tryndamere, he can't just walk through. Okay, very nice, we're doing quite well. We redeemed ourselves from our suicide to the Ezreal earlier. I can't believe I did that though. Like, it was like the most telegraphed death ever. Because he was just autoing me down, and I didn't ult. I was pressing ult, like, mind you, I was pressing R. I guess I was just too slow. Alright, there's the Kha'Zix. Pop a potion. Oh, he has that slow, huh? Alright. Ah, oh, I'm out of here. I had to flash there. I feel like he could use his Unseen Predator, and then it'll slow me again. This is a little bit risky to do Scuttle, but I think it's really important because Infernal Drake. Although it's up in 1 minute and Scuttle Crab lasts 60 seconds, so rip. Never mind. I'm going to get my Death Stance. I also recoil up outside the bush. Feels bad, man. Having a rough game. We're going to do a number to this Echo because we have freaking Death Stats and Phantom Dancer. Like, oh my god, this is the ultimate dueling build, guys. This Echo is not going to see the light of day if he fights us. He's going to be like, why am I doing no damage? Why do I do no damage? I hope they don't team fight because I can put so much pressure here. I'm going to rotate mid so that I could potentially join the team fight or at least just push out mid and continue the pressure anyway. I'm just gonna walk up to scare them. I got the slow on the bard, but I'm not going to go in on that. Oh, that's a dead Janna. Okay, I'm gonna rotate to top and my focus is this tower now. In hindsight, maybe I should have just kept pushing, but you never know, like they might actually go for the They might actually go for the Baron if I didn't rotate mid, so I wouldn't actually know if that was the best call. I probably didn't make the best call there. I think I should have just kept pushing bot, in all honesty. So, unfortunate right there. Graves didn't get the steal. He tried though, he tried. So, hopefully, since I see 4 on the map, I should be able to get this tower for free. We're also forcing a recall, so this is really good. So we're finally doing something right here. So LeBlanc's gonna go back, but she's not going to be able to save this tower. Actually, she didn't go back, so that means I can keep pushing. There's 2 on the map and 2 dead, so that means only 1 came back, if at all possible. If not, then that means no one came back. Okay, there's the Echo. Alright, we should be able to join them at Baron. Hopefully the Echo doesn't follow suit, and we should have a good time getting the Baron for free. Maybe. We do so much damage because we're Tryndamere and we have a Lucian here. Very nice, beautiful, I love this. So now we get our Merc Treads, and I'm going to get my IE. I could potentially get a Bork just because I personally love that item. I love the attack speed and scale so well with Eye Edge. I also don't get kited as easy, so that's why I want to build it. And also they have no tanks, so I don't need the Last Whisper. That's my reasoning for potentially getting a Bork. Because I just absolutely love that item. I love that item to pieces. I'm not going to follow Bard because everyone knows what happens when you follow a Bard. You get stunned on the other side and then he slows you and you just look like an idiot. At least that's what happens to me all the time. I'm always the idiot. So, I see a Kha'Zix. I don't like the look of this because I don't know where everyone else is, so I'm just gonna back off. Because of that value ward that I put earlier, when you attack this tower, you can actually put a ward over really far, and you'll be able to see a lot of things there. So I'm going to wait until they go away, and then I'm gonna start pushing again. Uh-oh. This doesn't look like a fight I can join, so I'm just going to push and force them back. So I force the Echo back. I'm also forcing the Kha'Zix back, so if I keep pushing, I'm actually going to suicide. Let me just see if Red is up. Red's not up. Okay, Kha'Zix is down there. Echo is back there, so I'm going to join the team fight. No, I'm not diving that. Nice. That was a good stun by the Nivea. Because I don't feel like I can go any further up. And we're just going to keep pressuring. I'm going to put the value ward over here. This is where you put a ward. If I had a pink ward, I'd put it there. Okay. My team knows fully well that the Echo is there, so it should be... They shouldn't die. And I should be able to just pull someone back again. Alright, back off. And if the Echo doesn't chase, it means the LeBlanc backed off as well. So yeah, LeBlanc backed off. Perfect. Yeah, we just have to keep being a menace until we get our Eye Edge. I think then we can be really aggressive. So, unfortunately, he cleared that ward. I'm going to have to be a lot more careful right now. Because all 5 are missing. And I have no wards. No trinkets. No trinket charges either. I see the LeBlanc. I see 3 on the map. And they're not at top lane, so this is relatively safe. I don't think an Ezreal and a Echo can do something crazy to me. Especially if I just pop out of nowhere just randomly and you know, take out that minion wave. So I do have my eye edge. I'm gonna go back for it because this is a really big power spike. And oh my god, it's a really bad time for them to fight when I just go back home. I'm going to try to get there as soon as I can. At least just as a chase prevention. Okay, so I'm going to need to pressure somewhere, so I'm going to pressure down here. I don't think there's much to do. The Lucian can counter tug of war with the enemy team, and Janna's really good at disengaging, so in that sense, we are good to just keep splitting. Since our team's actually like not going to instantly lose if I stop splitting. So in this sense, I can keep splitting. If it's any other game where my team's just non-stop feeding and, you know, the game's just going to end if I don't group, then that's when I have to group. Otherwise, Tryndamere, not so great of a team fighter or a group. I see the LeBlanc, that's the main threat. So, brought the Kha'Zix down here. LeBlanc is flanking us. I just saw that. But she's not getting any follow-up, so if she face checks this bush, I'm gonna ignite her and kill her. I don't think she is. Oh my god, she is. Alright, we got her. That's how you kill a LeBlanc, guys. But I had to burn my flash there. Had to burn my ignite and flash, just be super ham. I think that's what I learned from, say, you know, like Fogged, or I watched a couple of Fogged videos, and I noticed that he just plays a different, sort of different style. He's just super hyper-aggressive sometimes, and I'm thinking, oh, it's just a little bit questionable, but, you know, it actually works out. And I'm trying to implement that into my laning phase, is just to be a lot more aggressive. So that's how I got the kill on the Echo when I was behind. I was just always looking to try to all-in when I'm at even level, because Tryndamere has so much potential when he has Ignite. So there's the Ezreal. But the Echo is kind of floating in between. So I... Oh, I got the slow. Alright, he balked me as well. I feel like it might be too deep right now. So otherwise I would kill the Ezreal. It's actually... I should have went in. I should have just dove the Ezreal straight up. Man, they're going so ham. Alright, very nice. I distracted their back line as well. So I'm going to take their red buff, and then I'll heal up to full with it. And I should be able to continue the pressure, because we actually have a team this time, so this game's actually winnable. I can push this in. Since I'm already up here, it was the closest lane to red buff. And red buff was my ticket to healing, and also counter jungling, so that's why I went there. Oh, they are fighting, huh? Damn. Okay, hopefully nothing much comes out of it. Oh my god, why is the Nivea all the way up there? Okay, I should be able to cut them off. That Kha'Zix looks like he wants blood.
Stick around.
Alright, they all backed off. What can the Bard do, actually? Maybe I should have went on him. I just don't have flash. Okay, okay, LeBlanc, I am definitely getting out of here. Oh my god, this is bad. Oh my god, can I get out? I don't think I can. I'm pretty much dead, so I'm just wasting their time. Yeah, I couldn't get out there. That's unfortunate. I really hate LeBlanc because she can just chase you down from really far away, so super unfortunate right there. Do I dare get a GA? Man, I do want my Bork though. I really like my Bork. But I feel like GA is so good as well. I could be so ham and just not press Alt if I have GA. I think I'm gonna do it, guys. I'm going to get GA. I'm just going to, if I want to Alt, I'll just Alt really early, like at 50% health or 30% health. I'll ult early, that way it won't, you know, pop the GA at the same time with my ult. So I have to be careful of that because there is a known bug, guys, that if you were to ult around the time you're about to die, it will pop the GA and the ult. And since we're full build, we're going to get Elixir of Wrath, and we're just going to go for it. Man, I really don't like LeBlanc. I wish we banned her. Okay, we're going to push out. Wow, that was so messy. I really didn't know if I was going to get one-shotted or not. I'm going to loop around for the Ezreal. Should be a kill. Right here.
Fuck you.
Alright, very nice. LeBlanc's still up though. But that's a free inhib. I just hit the minion so I can heal. Okay, very nice. We're full health. And let's get Baron as well. This game's lasting a little longer than I would like it to. But yeah, over there, that was a boosted ultimate. I didn't know if I was going to die at one shot or not. It was just so messy, so cluttered. It was just a mess. So I just better safe than sorry, you know. Not that I was going to die because I have GA, but not necessarily want to... Oh my god. Okay. Man, she has the double dash, so she got away. But that was so scary. Imagine if she stole that. Jeez. Okay, just renew my wrath. Once I get enough gold, and if this GA pops, I'm going to change it into my Bork. I just, personal preference, guys. I know that double lifesteal isn't the best. But you know what? It's still good in my books. I still like it. I'm not keen on going on her. I'm pretty sure she has all her dashes. Although maybe I shouldn't have assumed. Not that I know if there was any, there was no vision of the enemy team. But yeah, it's questionable. If she was by herself, that definitely I should have went in. But it looks like potentially those guys could have been near her at that point. There's a lot of people here. Okay, nice. We got a Banshee's Veil. So the best thing I can do right now is to try to pressure this side. So just have maximum pressure. As I go behind enemy lines. And just push this in. So the moment a teamfight breaks out, I'm already in position to flank. Alright, got his Banshees. Looks like this is a tower. Okay, nice. We're just slowly dismantling their base. Alright, I guess he had to use his ult because I ignited him. So he was gonna die if he didn't ult. Very nice. That's a very good Janna ult. Oh, that's a dead Kha'Zix. Oh wow, he flashed at the same time I did. RIP. Okay, I have GA. That's fine. We can end off the game here. We get the plus 50. Very nice. GG, well played. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you guys learned a little something about maybe trying out a little bit of a more aggressive playstyle in lane, but also calculated. Make sure you don't die for it. But in terms of, you know, when you're behind, if you're, say, one level behind, try to get that next level and then just, you know, do those short trades in between and just fight him. Level 6, Tryndamere is just a beast. You can potentially kill people that are level 7 with your Ignite. So, yeah, hope you guys learned something. Thank you so much for watching to the very end, and I will see you guys in the next video. Just before I go, end score screen to show my boosted Diamond 5. Alright, thank you so much, guys. Cheers.